Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to look at an Autoland in the Airbus 320. We're here inside the Fenix in Microsoft Flight Simulator, and we're setting up for a CAT III B approach into Manchester's runway 5 left. And we're just circling at the end of the approach fix, and where we've got some pretty low cloud and poor visibility set up for the arrival. So conducting an autoland requires a lot of planning and briefing various points to ensure a safe outcome. One of the things we need to check first is the aircraft technical status. So we need to check for any defects that can affect the aircraft's landing capability. We need to make sure that on the approach, the FMA shows either a CAT II, CAT III single, or CAT III dual capability in order for an autoland to be able to go ahead. And in terms of the airport as well, we need to check the NOTAMs, anything relevant to the runway visual range, equipment not being in use, runway closures, lighting downgrades, or anything that could affect the airport capability. We also need to check the actual weather forecasts, the cloud base, the visibility, and they're two pieces of vital information required to ensure that the approach can be commenced. Another factor would be pilot currency in terms of how in the last 3 months with my operator, for example, we must have conducted an autoland approach, and that could be either in the sim or it could be in the real world, out there in flying the line, and we can fly an auto land in good visibility just to maintain that currency. So we'll be speaking to one another in the cockpit, you know, confirming that we've got that sort of recency in terms of having done an auto land approach as well. And that will vary from operator to operator, so depending on what operator you may be, you know, trying to represent within the simulator. So the autoland is very much designed in terms of how we operate run the cockpit environment, designed to be run with two crew. So within Microsoft Flight Simulator, we do have sort of increased workload. Again, it's one of those scenarios which is a little bit more difficult, and things can happen very quickly, particularly below 1,000 feet within the sim. So there's a number of different checks we need to do. Today we're going to go obviously all the way down, so CAT III B here. So if I bring up the approach plate actually for particular approach, you'll see that we've got no minimums here. We must have an RBR of 75 metres. Standard glide slope, 3 degrees today, transition altitude 5,000 feet, and platform altitude of 3,000 feet, inbound course 052. Obviously the data really important, especially your course. That's some things we need to check. We want to be checking our heights at these points, and this is where being dual crew, having someone cross check this information on your approach is really helpful. So something to be wary of when you're operating as one person in the sim. So we're going to enter note into our decision height in the radio field, because we're going to be using the radio altimeter, because it's a CAT III approach. We also want to make sure that our red autoland light is operating here. I want to check that before we commence an approach. So we'd obviously brief this up, make sure that we're going to get calls. Well, my pilot not flying would, you know, I'd ask to make check the height versus the distance from the runway as per the chart, and give me any deviations, whether I'm plus or minus on the approach. In terms of the pilot flying, it's a lot of eye scanning, so you'd be flicking your eyes from the navigation display to the outside. So you want to make sure you're set up a good seating position in the cockpit. We'll go flaps full for this. It gives us a bit more of a nose down pitch, allows better visibility of approach lights. So flaps full is preferable on a CAT III where we can. Things obviously happen below 1,000 feet. There's a number of different checks we need to undertake. So on an Autoland, as we get to 1,000 feet, we want all ECAM actions to be complete, and we need to be stable at 1,000 feet. At 900 feet, our TCAS system will downgrade to TA only. At 800 feet, we'll have landing inhibit mode until the aircraft accelerates below 80 knots. At 700 feet, the FMGC data lock will lock our course, frequency, and performance page. And we need to run a stable check at 500 feet. At 350 feet, we need land green appearing here on the flight mode annunciator, and that will lock our FCU modes up here. At that point, we also need to check that we're on the correct course. The course is, you know, looking good in terms of the ILS. If we get the red auto land up here at 200 feet, that's a go around. At 40 feet, we need the green flare mode annunciator here, otherwise that's a go around. But that doesn't appear on the FMA at 40 feet. And 30 feet we're thrust idle, and then we want to check we're rolling out, and we'll have some guidance here in terms of runway centerline as well. So above 1,000 feet we'll go around with any issues. Between 1,000 feet and 100 feet, we get a downgrade in such as an autopilot disconnect, a loss of CAT III, so you get the free clicks, and that, you can get that in the cockpit, an amber caution single chime, or an engine failure, that will all reason for a go around. At 350 feet, if we do not get land green appear here, that's a go around as well. And below 200 feet, we'll go around for a red Autoland light, loss of autopilots, a localizer deviation of quarter of a dot, glide slope deviation of 1 dot, and a radio altimeter discrepancy of 15 feet between either side. And if we have a long, early, or untimely flare on the landing as well. And again, at flare height, if we don't get the flare mode annunciator here, come up. Again, that's a go around as well. So a lot happens below 1,000 feet, which is, you know, it's a lot for one pilot to be monitoring and keeping an eye on during that stage of the flight, but just important to understand those, you know, that's the requirements to get down safely and all those various checks that should be undertaken. Okay, we're now intercepting the localizer for 05 left at Manchester. Lockstar CAT III dual is displayed on the FMA, so that's showing we've got that capability for an autoland with no decision height selected. Also to add, if any pilot, either pilot, feels unhappy with the approach, the safest thing to do is go around. And once we put our trust in the aircraft capabilities and the ground equipment operating correctly, if the instinct of the pilot's questioned, then conduct a go around. Then once, you know, back in a safe environment, discuss the reasons and for the missed approach and plan next options. Glide slope star. I'm just beginning our descent down now, so missed approach altitude 3000 is set. side slope. Check. Important at this stage, particularly on a CAT III approach, to cross check those radio altimeters. Again, we're looking for tolerance of 15 feet between both of them, either side, with the first officer and the pilot flying side. Inside. Apps 2. X. Apps 2. Get down. Oil is armed. Apps 3. Apps 3. Some heavy rain, so we're going to go to ignition mode and flaps full, speed checks, flaps full. So you want to be stable at 1,000 feet and all ECAM actions complete. We did our approach checklist. Cabin secure for landing, go around altitude is 3,000 set. Landing memo, ECAM, no blue. In and out of check 1000, so yeah, we're stable at 900 feet. The TCAS will downgrade to TA only. We've got on the navigation display 800 feet. We've got landing inhibit to below 80 knots. Flight management guidance computer data lock, so we're locking the course and the frequency and the performance page. We've got landing inhibit there on the ECAM, upper ECAM. 500 feet stable, which we're cool. 350 feet, we're looking for land green here on the. There we go, land green we have. We're just keeping an eye out to ensure there's no red autopilot lights. And we want to check for that flare being annunciated as well on the. FMA at 40 feet. Out of the throttles, and you see here in the middle of the primary flight display, that's our centre line tracking of the runway, so we keep an eye on that, particularly poor visibility. Here we do have visuals with the lights and centre line. So we've got reverse, decel, spoilers, 70 knots, reverse idle, and we can go manual braking. Wait for poor braking today, this is sounding water. And yeah, obviously at some point you want to disconnect the autopilot so you can taxi off. There you have it. Lots to think about on the Autoland, particularly below 1,000 feet. There's lots of little checks that happen there. Ideally, we'd want the pilot not flying there as well, calling out deviations and just monitoring that progress down. So, pilot not flying would be solely looking at the primary flight display, looking for the deviations, you know, calling out glide slope or localizer deviation and cross-checking with the charts in terms of distance from runway, the runway and altitude. So that's really important and something that's quite difficult to do in the sim, but I'd encourage you to just have a go with that and make sure that you are stable at 1,000 feet. I think that's really important, otherwise it's just going to go wrong. Too much will happen too quickly. If you're unstable at 1,000 feet, go around and set up again. Any questions on that, drop them into the chat and I'll do my best to answer them. Please like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.